Hey guys, it's Robsy, back with Paperless X, a channel dedicated to easing your digital transformation. In today's video, we'll be going through Apple Journal. If you're new to our channel, hello. Make sure you subscribe and turn on your notifications so you know each time we release a new video. And if you're already subscribed, fantastic human, welcome back. Journal by Apple is a free journaling app that is available on the iPhone and it comes pre-installed with iOS 17. It is not available on any other device, which we have mixed feelings about. The app can lock the journal once you've added some entries. It uses your iPhone passcode and supports Face ID, which makes it easy to lock your entries. But for more security, a different password would be better. It just makes it that much harder to access your journal. If you have no secrets to hide, you can choose not to lock your journal altogether. We appreciate the dedication to minimalism. Apple Journal is the simplest journaling app on the market. Too simple for what we expected from Apple to release. A simple journaling app is refreshing, but we couldn't help but wonder how functional it actually is. Creating a new journal is pretty easy. There is no way you're going to miss the massive plus icon for creating new entries. If you don't know where to start, the app gives you some suggestions on things you can write about. Each has 5 ideas, and we're curious if these will change over time or they just remain the same. Where the app keeps suggesting the same things till you've written about them, and only after that you start getting new ideas. If you're using Apple Journal as your journaling app, let us know how the suggestions work if you're using them. You can suggest from your media, contacts, photos, and even locations, which gives you quite a lot of options to get suggestions on. However, if you don't want any suggestions, you can simply turn them off, and we love those options. You can type your thoughts till your heart is content. We like the idea of a simple journal, something that you can take with you everywhere, and jot down random ideas when they come to you. The app has some basic formatting options that are a bit of work to bring up. The app has practically no user interface, so there's enough space to add formatting options at the top to make them more accessible. We love that the app supports many different types of attachments that you can add to a single entry. Journal lets you add photos, videos, audio recordings, and even bookmark locations. That is all the type of information you'd probably want to attach to a journal entry. Do you think they missed anything? Placing all the attachments at the top of the entry, clustered together, makes for a terrible journal entry though. It's bad enough we can't interact much with our images, but we can't even choose where they go. That was a massive deal breaker for me. When journaling, and I'm talking about a tree that I took a picture of, I would like to put that tree next to where I mention it. It is the most logical way to structure journals. Apple couldn't even bring in the setup we have in Apple Notes that blocks types of notes from images. That setup works so much better than what we have in Journal. It would have worked great in Journal, especially because the app is limited to the iPhone. The screen is so small, so simply having images mixed with text would look great without really putting much effort on where it goes. Stickers could have made a decent workaround, but unfortunately, the app doesn't support stickers. Only emojis. So we're stuck with no control over where our images go. At least tapping on the attachments immediately opens them up and we can scroll through all the attachments for that journal entry. That organization makes it easy to find items that are related to each other. Apple Journal supports dark mode, which is great if you want to journal under your blanket. We were expecting to have widgets for the app though, and we don't have that. The organization in the app is simple and in chronological order, but there are no folders in the app. That's probably something they're working on, right? Or do all the entries for a single year or month just automatically group together? We like that each entry has a date, but a timestamp would be great to have as well. Who else likes timestamps for their journal entries, especially when you write multiple entries in a single day? It helps to know when each was written. The filters are quite helpful when you want to focus on specific entries. When you have too many entries, you will definitely love this feature, especially because the app has no search tool. That's unbelievable. No search tool for a document app. Are we really supposed to scroll through all the entries to find what we want to go through? Or does Apple just want us to journal and never look at the entries ever again? Do you ever go through your past journal entries? Do tell. So many questions, such few answers. Apple Journal is simple, but it still needs a bit of work and it's missing some essentials to make the app more functional. Typing in your journal on the go makes sense, though it has more cons than pros. Handwriting in a journal is great, but typing also has its place. Since we're used to texting, some of us will like Apple Journal as it feels like you're texting yourself. What do you guys think about Apple Journal and have you tried it? Let us know. We hope you guys liked this video. Give it a thumbs up. If you did, thank you, fantastic human, for watching. See you in the next video.